translation technology or like it's something new to you?
Tableau.
Yeah, no, anywhere, anything like data visualization or data related for things you have done earlier, or it's something new to you?
This is something new to me.
Okay, so your background is like from computer science or other?
My bachelor's is from computer science. My master's is in project management.
Okay, that's good. So like at least you will be aware of like some SQL code and all that stuff.
Okay.
Yeah, okay, that but it's like just it's not a recommend necessary thing, but it's just helpful because this is for like your like whenever you go ahead in Tableau, and it will be helpful for you. So just start with let's start with the introduction. So like Tableau is a data visualization tool. It is helping us to create reports and dashboards so that we can analyze the data and see the trends and patterns, what all is hiding in the data. So that is what like Tableau is. Okay. So why do we need this thing? First of all, let's understand why do we need this like technology, or what is the need of this thing? So like business is having a lot of data. They are like working on huge volume of data, and every business, whether you're working as a like in finance company or banking or any energy, anything retail, any kind of data, whatever like business or domain you are working in, it is generating a lot of data. Okay, and business is already using some kind of reports for a long time. You might have worked on Excel reports and all that. Okay, you might have created like a pivot and pivots and all that stuff to get some insights of the data. But that is what like you have been working for a long time, and business is also working on the same thing. They are using Excel reports, they are using Crystal reports, SSRS, Cognos, business objects. These are the technologies which are there for a long time in the market. Okay. Now, like the problem in these technologies is that like they cannot handle huge volume of data. The reporting period is long. Okay. So to create a report, you have to wait for months. Okay. So because of that, what happens? The decision-making time is longer here. Okay. So business has to wait for a long time to make a decision or to do the analysis and all that. By the time they do their analysis, means like something is lost. Okay, so that is the purpose. Like they need a technology which can help them to see the insights quickly, very user friendly. Means like it should be very user friendly. Okay, visualization should be very good. Okay, intuitive and interactive visualizations, and they can see the insights quickly as soon as possible. Okay, and here comes the Tableau in the picture. Tableau is the leader in the market. You might have heard about that. Tableau is currently leading from 4 years straight forward. Like it is leading the market in data visualization tools or technologies. Okay, it's a leader in the first rank like from last 4 years, consecutive for like 4 years. Okay, and it's a data visualization tool, so which helps us to analyze and visualize the data. So what is a Tableau like? Tableau is a data analytical tool that allows people to explore data and analyze data with simple drag and drop operations. You don't have to write a lot of code things. You don't have to write a lot of code or like these things like where you have to do. But here in Tableau, what happens? You can just drag and drop operations, and you can easily work on and create reports and dashboards. Okay, so that's why we use it. So it's an in-memory analytical tool. In-memory means whatever data you are bringing, that will stay in the memory of data engine of like Tableau server. And the processing speed, the calculations, the aggregations, what all you will be doing, all that will be very fast. Okay, that's why like you're
Okay.
getting your results, your queries are running very fast here. Okay, it is one of the best data visualization tool. That's why I told you that it's a leader in the market. It helps us to find the trends and patterns quickly, which are hiding in the data. See, whatever business you are working or wherever you are working, so that is generating a lot of data. Even your Twitter, even your Facebook, your LinkedIn, all these websites, all these social network sites, all these generate a lot of data, isn't it?
Yes.
So that is getting stored somewhere. If you must be doing a lot of banking transactions and all that. So that is again data. So that is getting stored. So if you want to analyze that amount of data, you have to find out that huge volume of data is there. You never know what all is hiding in the data until unless you analyze it. So to find what is hidden in the data, you have to analyze it. Then only you will bring up the threats or opportunities. It can be threats to your business, or it can be opportunities to your business. You never know until unless you analyze it. Okay? So that is what like we want to see, that in which like your product is working or not, your sales are going in the right direction or not. How will you see that? By analyzing the data. So that's what we do in Tableau. It can connect to any kind of data source. This is the USP like of Tableau or any other technology like that, that it can connect to any kind of sources. See, you are working in a business where like you are using SQL Server, okay? I might be using like Oracle, or someone else might be using, let's say, Teradata. So that's all. It doesn't restrict that you can use this one or that one. No, you can connect to any kind of data source to load the data and do your analysis. You can connect to Excel file, flat files, to spreadsheets, okay, and to any of these like Access, MS Access, OData, SQL Server, Oracle, Teradata, ODBC connection, MongoDB, Big Data, Web Services, Amazon Redshift, Google Analytics. There's 50 plus data sources which can connect to Tableau. That's what Tableau gives you an edge, that no matter what database you have, where your data is residing, it doesn't matter. You can connect it through Tableau and load it and do your analysis. That's how like, see, that's what like, see, if you have a mobile, if you are purchase an iPhone or something, okay, and it says, no, I cannot like take any other SIM other than let's say Airtel, okay? So what, will you go with that? Obviously no. So you would like to have a product which can connect to any kind of SIM. Today you might be using your Airtel, okay, that is fine. But tomorrow you want to move to some other place, some other country where that service provider is not there, but your product has failed there. So obviously you would like to have a product which can connect to any kind of data sources and load the data. Today you might be using like say Teradata or SQL. Tomorrow your business will grow, your data sources will be different. In that case, you have to have a product which can connect to those sources also. So that is why Tableau is more popular in the market. And it is feasible, this complete thing, what we are discussing here, that like drag and drop operations, very easily we can do all this stuff. So this is all feasible with the help of VisQL. That is one of the component here that is called Visual Query Language. So whatever drag and drop operations you are doing, actually for you, it will be just drag and drop. But for backend data server, okay, the Tableau server, this is happening because of Visual Query Language. So at the backend, the query is running, because of which you get good performance and your drag and drop operations comes into some meaningful information. Okay. And then you can analyze and explore data with intuitive and interactive visualizations. Okay, that is why like it is more useful. Okay, and these are the products what you will be working in. So we have Tableau Desktop. So this is used to create the reports and dashboard. Let's suppose you join a project. Okay, you must be joining a project where like you will be asked to work on Tableau. So what product you will be using, where you will be working, so that will be Tableau Desktop. So which you can even download on your local machine or your laptop. You can download the trial version and start working on it. Start learning it by yourself. Okay. So this will be helping you. So let's say if you're going into sessions in training, so we'll be discussing a lot of stuff and you can practice by your own, okay, at the back, at your place. So this will be helpful for you. So Tableau Desktop, so that is a product which will be used in real time. That, but Tableau Desktop, what you will be downloading, that is a trial version. So that will come with 40 days trial version. Okay. But in real time projects, you will be using license version. So which will be available for you. Then,
okay,
you have created reports and dashboards. Now you have to share it with the users. Now you have to share it with your users. Okay, you have created a report or dashboard. You might be sharing with your managers, senior manager, directors, and all that. Okay, how will you share it with them? They won't have desktop. They will access the reports using some browsers. So what do you have to do? You have to create reports in desktop and save them in server. Okay, so when you save reports in server, a URL is generated for each report. Okay, so sharing on the web, security, administration, all that is done in the server side. So when the URL is generated for each report, so what that URL will do, you have to just share that URL to your users through emails. Okay, and your users can click on that link and they will be able to access the reports what you have created. Okay, it's like for them, for users, remember, for users don't need any kind of software. Okay, software is all what you need as a developer or Tableau analyst, whatever you want to call it. Okay, users just need internet connection and a browser, that's all, nothing else. Okay, and access or permissions to view the report. Okay, Tableau server. And you know, Tableau server, when I'm saying Tableau server, it means I have to install it on server machines, Windows machines or Linux machines. Okay, so it will be on premises. It will be on premises. Okay, so on premises means like your company is there. Let's say it's something like you have your own servers where you want to install it. Okay, so you have the control on the servers and everything. Okay, but in this case, what will happen? Obviously, your cost will increase. I'm just talking about the business, business from the business side, not from your developer side and all that. But still, you have to know all these concepts. Okay, mm-hmm. So it's like purchasing a car by yourself. So when you want to go from one place to another place, for that you have purchased a car. So purchased a car, maintenance will be there. Okay, refueling will be there all the time. Okay, so all that stuff will accumulate into a cost. Okay, now you have another thing called Tableau Online. This is one thing where you don't have to do anything on your side. You can ask Tableau to provide you online access. So it's like rent a service, the way you know nowadays, like we use cloud services and all. So mm-hmm. I hope like you will be aware of cloud services. Okay, so the way you have Gmail, it's not your account. You have taken some space from company called Google. They are giving you a service that is Gmail. That Gmail is nothing but cloud-based email service, isn't it? Same thing. So here in Tableau Online, what happens that servers are not physically maintained by you or by your business. Okay. So you can purchase these servers on from Tableau, but that is for Tableau Online. In that case, you don't have to maintain, you don't have to upgrade. Everything will be done from Tableau side only. So that is called Tableau Online thing. It is a bit cheaper than server and all that. Okay, then you have Tableau Public. Tableau Public is a like a platform which is publicly available. You can download it and there is no expiry of this thing. Tableau Desktop will be expired after 14 days. You can install it again, no issues in that, with new email ID and all that. Okay, but Tableau Public is something which you can download on your machine. Okay, and it will not expire, but this comes with few limitations. Okay, like that you cannot save any of the files on your local machine. If you want to have save, like in saving some report or dashboards, you have to save it on public folder only, and that is on cloud. Okay, on some website, cloud TIBCO public website, where only there only you can save it. So in office environments, we never use public because our data is confidential. So we cannot share those data or that particular data with others. Okay, public data. So we don't use public for office environment. Okay, we use this for learning and training purpose and all that. We can use it. And Tableau Reader is there. This Tableau Reader can open any of Tableau desktop files. Okay, but it is only readable, not editable. Then you have Tableau Mobile. As you know now, like everyone wants to go with mobile devices and all. So there, what they do, like you will be like doing the same thing. We all do the same thing. We do movies, we do tickets, booking, shopping, everything we like to do through mobile. Same way, business wants to access their reports and dashboards through mobile devices. They don't want to open reports or dashboards, okay, through laptop. They will open the laptop, they will connect to their VPN, okay, and then they will access the report. It's not advisable if the person is going on the go, okay, is in a meeting with business, some clients and all that. They can open their iPads, they can open their iPhones, and quickly they can access the reports. So that's how it is. This how like convenience we are giving, like as a Tableau is giving to you or to users. They can access the reports and dashboards. Especially, you can create mobile-based applications directly. So in while creating a report, you can specifically say that this is only for Tableau Mobile or means that you can define it there, whether it's an iPad or like iPhone kind of thing. Okay, that's you have options to select there, iPad, iPhone. Okay, so those options are there to select. So that will be specifically created for that. So these are the options what you will be seeing, but that depends what kind of environment you are going to join. Means like what kind of project you are going. Based on that, you will see or you may not see all these products. Most probably, you will be accessing desktop and server installation and mobile. Reader public online may not be available for you because in big projects and all that, companies or business are not like they will not be thinking of just saving few, let's say $10,000 or something like that. Okay, So they won't care about that when they want go with quality and confidentiality of the data and all that. In that case, they won't care of like $10,000 something. Okay, so you may not be using these things. But if the project is like say something like based on so they want to save some money or let's say they have some kind of constraint, okay, then online will be used. But it depends upon project to project. Any doubts in this? Any questions in this? Any products? But remember,
No.
you will be using desktop for creating reports and dashboards. This is one thing you have to always remember. We'll be working all our training parts and everything on desktop only. Okay? And server also we'll be covering. This is
Okay.
a Tableau like architecture, what you will be seeing like from like server side. Okay. That's what I told you here is a gateway. Gateway means where you create reports, where you save reports, where you publish the reports. Okay, all that is here you see like Windows, iOS, and Android. All that can be accessed on like mobile devices. Okay, so here you have your server side, Windows or Linux. Okay, it can be enterprise data center, it can be private cloud, okay, your own cloud, or it can be public cloud, AWS, Azure, Google Cloud. You can install or configure your Tableau servers environment anywhere. That's all up to you or your business requirement. Okay, then your installation is done. Then you have repository and file store where you save all your reports, dashboards. Okay, repository is there. And then we have some services. So these are called some like components which are running at the back end, which are doing everything. Whatever you are doing, all those data like calculation, extract, all that extract doing is there, and BigQuery is there. All that processes are running at the back end. So backgrounder, data services, and data engine. This takes care of all the extracts. So we have something called extract in Tableau. The extract is nothing but like storing the data in Tableau file. Okay, so all those are done using backgrounders. BigQuery server. So that's what I told you. BigQuery server means visual query language, which translates your drag and drop operations to some meaningful information. Cache server. Cache server is nothing but caching. So if you want to cache some data, like say for better performance and all that, you can store the data and you can refresh it regularly. So that caching will be done using cache server. Application server is a server which controls everything, your server side security, folder structure, permissions, licenses. Okay, all that are defined through this. Then your data services to connect to any kind of databases, any kind of data sources. Here you see 50 plus data connectors are available for connecting to databases. Okay, content managing and share and collaboration services to share with other users and all. Okay, you can always use these things. And then gateway is a front-end application. Okay, front-end means like for you as developers, okay, or for us again as users. So we will be developers who will be working on desktop, Tableau desktop, which can create reports and dashboards. We will publish them to servers, and through them, my users will access the reports. So this is how the real-time like workflow works. This is the architecture, same thing what I showed you. Okay, so Tableau is a highly scalable end-to-end client-server architecture, client and server. Server side, client is our side where we work. Okay, that serve mobile clients, web clients, and desktop installed softwares. So Tableau desktop is the authoring and publishing tool that is used to create or share views on Tableau server. Views is nothing but reports or dashboards. See, you can call it reports, you can call it dashboards, you can call it templates. People call it different names. So, and coming from 10.5, the latest version in market is 10.5.3. But recently, last week itself, Tableau has changed the release kind of thing. The way they used to release till now, that is changed. So now they have released a new version, which is called as 2018.1. Now on, whatever release they will be doing, it will be coming like that. 2018.1, 2018.2, like that. So in 2019, they will say like that, 1, 2, like. So the naming will be done like that. But remember, latest version is 10.5 or 2018.1. Okay. From 10.5 version, they have introduced something called hyper technology. Okay, this is something new and advanced topic. Firstly, just for information, from Tender 5, they have introduced something called Hyper Technology. Okay, this is used to do extract thing. Okay, this is for faster performance of the reports, like, and dashboards, whatever you are creating. So what is the benefit what we are getting? So faster extract creation, that's what I told you. Extract is something where we store the data into the analysis file. Support for larger extracts, faster analysis for extracts. Okay, so this is like something new. Okay. So Hyper Technology is designed to consume data faster. Hyper Technology is memory optimized to have better performance. Hyper Technology is CPU optimized again for better performance. Okay, it's compiling. So query whatever you are, it is already compiled. So you will always get the better. So this is all Hyper Technology. What is done here? This is only for better performance, so that you can load huge volume of data, extract huge like data. Okay. And you can easily get your reports and dashboards embedded. So what are the things like, why this Tableau is so popular? So remember one thing, like Tableau is popular and it is getting more and more traction nowadays just because it is very user friendly and it is easy to learn. Okay, within a couple of months you can be good in Tableau. Okay, if you practice daily or let's say regularly, within a couple of months you can have a good grasp on this technology. But you know, like learning is always a continuous process. You cannot be expert in 2 months, but you can go have a good like base on that. But there are a lot of things, lot of advanced stuff, real-time requirements where you people will ask you do this, do that, and you have to come up with some solutions. You have to always explore new things, new options. Okay, so that is a continuous process. Visual analytics, why this is use more useful? Visual analytics, forecasting, visual groups, shear filters, all that thing we can do. Fast performance, that is what we are getting here. Old reports are taking a lot of time. You might have seen that if you open thousands of records in Excel or Excel report, it takes just 5 minutes, 10 minutes just to open it. Okay, but here it will open in just seconds. Any kind of data which can be loaded can be connected to Tableau. You can load any kind of data, any big data, anything, web services, Google Analytics, anything, Google BigQuery, anything you can connect. Business integration, then you can embed your Tableau reports to your own portals. Your company might be having websites or web portals. Okay, so your reports and dashboards can be integrated to those portals. Web and mobile authoring. So web and mobile authoring is nothing but like, let's say, that's what I told you, that mobile authoring, you can edit the reports in web also. You can render your visualizations in mobile devices. That is the best thing nowadays people are looking for. These are the work files, like Tableau file types, what you will be working on. So Tableau workbook is called TWB. Any file which contains sheet and dashboard, that is called a workbook. And that is the extension of the file is called TWB. You have to remember these things if you are going to work on Tableau. You have to remember all these. Okay. But two or three will be more popular and more used. So the one is TWB, WBX, TDS, and TTE. These are mostly used. TWBX means the file, whatever you have in TWB, along with the data. Okay, TDS is the data source, connection details. TDSX is the package source along with the data and connection details. TDE is only extract, only data is extracted, which you can save it in library, your like repository where you have a server. Then you can create bookmarks or preferences that also can be saved by users or by you also as a developer, Tableau developer. Any doubts here? Any question?
No.
Okay. So this is like just an example, like why Tableau, and then you will start getting. So if I ask you that, can you get me the insights of this thing? Then it is tough, really tough, like, to get the insights. But if I put this data into Tableau here, you see that how quickly I can see the trends and patterns. I can see the sales for every state and which state is giving me the highest, and which, here you see California is giving me the highest sales, which is comes under West region. Okay, and then sales profit analysis, here you have sales bars is your sales, and your line, what you're getting, this is profit. So this way, like, here you see dual axis chart. This is dual axis, one y axis, one right y axis. So this is called dual axis chart, yearly categorized and quarterly categorized. Okay, so this way, like we can see more and more. This is just a snapshot, but in real time, Tableau reports are dynamic. Remember, Tableau reports and dashboards are dynamic. There is nothing called static there. Users will be playing around with the data. They will filter the data. They will see the trends happening. They will see the visualization changing, data changing. So everything is dynamic there. This is just a reason you are seeing it there. And you can see that more and more visualizations, more and more charts. That's how you are going to get it. So to work on a Tableau or to work as a Tableau developer, what you need? So you just need to have a basic understanding of charts. What is line chart? What is bar chart? What is pie chart? Okay, that's all like you need to have. If you are not aware of this thing, I hope you will be aware of this. But still, if you are not sure that what need to be used and how to be used, where to be used, I will share a few things with you. That will be helpful like for the newcomers like who are starting on this thing, that where to use line chart, in what scenarios we should use which chart. Okay, that thing is very important. Look for data and numbers, that's what I'm calling it, so that you can work on the data. You should understand the data, what the data is trying to say, find out the deep dive into the data, and then get the insights from the data. That is the main thing. Basic understanding of SQL queries, this is required, basic understanding, so that you can, this can be easily learned, no issues in that, but basic understanding is required so that you can modify, or like if there is something, you can customize it. There might be some requirements. Logical thinking, main thing is logical thinking. And since you are a computer graduate, like so you must be aware of that, all the functions or case statements, if conditions and that stuff. Well, logical thinking is the main thing. Okay, if I have to write some calculation, if I don't know that how to write an if condition, then like how will I do some calculation? So logical thinking is very important. Okay, not only here, any kind of business, any kind of work you are doing. So what are the job prospects like, may or may not be like relevant to you, but still you should be aware that Tableau developer, Tableau consultant, reporting analyst, data analyst, business intelligence developer, data scientist, these are the four roles like which you will be seeing if you want to apply for a job or something. Then like these are the roles, people will call it developers, consultant, but it's actually same. If you are a senior resource, if you are having a lot of experience, you may be working on the Tableau, but your role might be something called, let's say, program manager, or let's say programmer lead or project lead kind of thing. Okay, but still you will be working on Tableau. So this is just like introduction. What I have just given you a brief introduction about Tableau. So any questions, any doubts?
No, I don't have any questions so far, but will you be able to share the slides with me?
Slide, I can share. Okay, so that can be shared, like, if you have any other questions, like you can ask anything related to training and all that. If you have any questions, you can always check with.
Actually, one thing I wanted to ask is, although I am from computer science background, I have 8 years of work experience in finance domain. So I have not worked on what I have studied, and what I worked is different. So I don't have knowledge of SQL. So will you be also training about the queries in Tableau?
I can tell you the things like basic stuff, but it is not like I can train you in that. So I'll be, if you want, I can help you to learn the queries. I can help you to write the queries, how to understand that, all I can help you in that. But it is not that I can train you completely. So that is not our like the scope. But I'll take few sessions definitely. If you are like going with this, then I can help you in that. So I'll be taking few sessions only on SQL, where I teach you SQL. I can teach you like how to fetch data, how to create joins, how to create like unions, how to create, use the functions. Okay, that I can help you in that.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah. Any questions, any doubts?
No.
Okay, so if you have any questions, you can always reach out to Prakash. So he'll be like guiding you, and if you need any technical help or anything, I'll be there in that.
Okay.
Okay.
Thank you.
Okay, thank you very much.
Thank you so much. Bye.